everyone, and a very warm welcome to our St George's Day recital given today by R.B. Stansfield. We have a marvellous and patriotic programme put together for us to enjoy, and you're also able to read something about R.B. from his biographical notes. It's a return visit, and we're also very grateful that 2 years ago, during lockdown, R.B. was one of the first of our virtual recitalists as well. So it's great to welcome him back in the flesh. Please give a very warm welcome to R.B. Stansfield.
thank Eric indeed for that warm welcome, Father Neil. And it's a great pleasure to be back with you here live in church. So that was Elgar's Imperial March, and what a way to start with that very pomposo march. We'll now go on to Herbert Brewer's Cloister Garth. Herbert Brewer was organist at Gloucester Cathedral, and this title, Cloister Garth, comes from their picturesque cloister in the cathedral. So you'll hear that and perhaps picture that scenic view whilst you hear that. And then following Elegy by Falcon Ball, which was seems to be said an improvisation that he did for a radio broadcast, but equally a very nice solemn, and you'll hear some very nice colours of the organ. And then to our three ending pieces, now returning to a more trumpet tune. This has a nice story with it. It's written by a colleague and friend of mine, Anthony White, who's in his final year at Aberdeen, studying composition, and he wrote this for me while I was organ scholar at Coventry Cathedral. So it's great to give it its live performance today, so I'm in for a treat there. And then finishing with some very light-hearted Whitlock, a nice quiet reflection, and finishing with a rather brilliant piano.